Hello, welcome again. We are solving questions from thermal engineering. The topic is gas turbine, IC engine and air compressor. Question number 60 to 63 has common statement. The statement is a reciprocating compressor is to be designed to compress 4.5 kg per minute of air from 100 kPa at and 27 degrees Celsius through an overall pressure ratio of 9. The law of compression is PV raised power 1.3 constant, neglect clearance volume. Question number 60 is the power consumption if the speed is 1000 rpm. Option A 17.2 kilowatt, option B 18.5 kilowatt, option C 56.1 kilowatt, option D 25.2 kilowatt. Thermal efficiency is option A 68.12%, option B 76.72%, option C 72.1%, and option D 75.1%. Okay. Now, when a two stage compressor with complete intercooling is used in place of single stage compressor, assuming equal pressure ratio in both the stages of two stage compressor, then saving in power consumption is option A 12.11 kilowatt, option B 16.08 kilowatt, option C 15.11 kilowatt, and option D 14.3 kilowatt. In above case, gain in isothermal efficiency is option A 8.57%, option B 11.55%, option C 12.15%, and option D 13.25%. So this is your diagram, and now the pressure is given as 100 kPa, and initial temperature is given at 27 degrees Celsius, and the law of compression is PV 1.3 constant. So as law of as it is given that the clearance volume has been neglected, so the diagram, PV diagram, should be like that. So this is your intake, this is your compression, and according to law, PV raised power 1.3 constant, and this is your exhaust. Okay. So area of this diagram, area of this diagram will give volume. So here the suppose here the volume is V2, and here the volume is V1, and pressure is P1, and here pressure is P2. So the work done will be given by P2 V2 minus P1 V1, and area under this curve. Okay, and area under this curve is P2 V2 minus P1 V1 and minus 1. Okay. So P2 V2 is your MRT2. And P1 V1 is your MRT1, so it is MRT2 minus T1 plus MRT2 minus T1 divided by N minus 1. Okay. So putting the value of P2 V2 as MRT2 and putting the value of P1 V1 as MRT1. Okay, so it will be your MRT2 minus T1 N divided by N minus 1. So M is mass of air, that is 4.5. So mass is 4.5 kilo, mass of air is 4.5 kilogram per minute. So, or in second it will be 4.5 by 60. R is 287, N is 1.3, and initial temperature is here 27 degrees Celsius or 300 degrees Kelvin, and T2 is from this isentropic relation we can find out using that P rate of 1.3 is equal to constant. We can find T2. So T2 by T1 is equal to T2 by T1 raised power N minus 1 by N. So this ratio is 9, so that is 0.3 by 1.3. So T2 will be your 498 Kelvin. Okay, so T2 is your 498 Kelvin. Now we can put the value of T2, and we have value of T1, we have value of R, we have value of M, and value of N. So we can find out the power consumption, that is 18. Putting this value, we can get 18.47 kilowatt or is 1 is 4 coming to 1. Okay. Now when isothermal work is done, okay, then this process is isothermal. Okay, then when isothermal work is done, so then it will be this process will remain same. This process will remain same. Just this process will be replaced by isothermal work done. Okay, and isothermal work done is P1V1 ln P2 by T1. And as temperature is, as the pressure is isothermal, so P2V2 will be equal to P1V1. So this will be same. So the isothermal work done will be P1V1 ln P2 by T1, MRT1 ln P2 by T1. Okay. So M is a 4.5 by 60, R is 287, T1 is 300, and ln P2 by T1 is 9. So it will be isothermal work done will be 14188.57 baht, or it will be 14.188 kilowatt. Okay. So this is your isothermal work done, and isothermal efficiency, isothermal work done divided by actual work done. So isothermal work done is 14.188 divided by 18.470. So actual work done is this, and isothermal work done is this. So isothermal efficiency is 76.81%. Okay. So isothermal work done is isothermal work done. Or isothermal efficiency, isothermal work done divided by actual work done, that is 76.81%. Okay. So isothermal efficiency. Okay. Now next question is, then it is replaced by a two-stage compressor and with perfect intercooling. For perfect intercooling, the ambient temperature should be root of two pressure, and the two pressures are 9 bar and 1 bar. So 9 into 1000, so 9 into 100 will be 900 kPa, and this will be 100 kPa, and this will be 300 kPa. Okay. And work done in single stage is given by MR T2 minus T1 into N divided by N minus 1. Okay, so M is 4.5 by 60 and R is 287, and T2 minus T1 is not known. Okay, so that is so N is 1.3 by 1.3. Now T2 by T1 is your T2 by T1, which was 0.3 by 1.3. Okay, and P2 by P1 is 3. Pressure ratio in the first stage is 3. So T2 is your 386.58. This is your first this is pressure ratio in first stage. Okay, and this is your N, because T1 is your 27 degree Celsius, so we can have T2. So here only missing one by T2, T1 by T2. And if we put the value of T2 and T1, then we can find out the volume. So that is 8074 baht. And as the work done to stages are same, so W1 will be 8074 baht in both the stages. And total work done is 8074 into 2 or 161.4149 baht. So answer to this question is answer to question number 60 is B. So that is total work done. Okay. Now next is work done during as we found out that the work done during the isothermal process is 14.88 kilowatt. So that will remain same whether it's single stage or multi stage. Okay. And isothermal efficiency will be your isothermal work done divided by actual work done, so that will be 87.85%. So now the efficiency is 87.85%, and the previously the efficiency was 76.81%. So the gain in efficiency will be 87.85 minus 76.7 minus 11.135%. So option is 63. Option B is the right answer.